Hello students, welcome back to our Python online classes. Today I am going to explain about nested decision structures. Nested decision structures. So today's concept is nested decision structures. Actually, in the last class we have already discussed about the introduction part of decision structures. In that, how many types we have? If condition, if statement, if else statement, if elif else statement, and next nested statement. The last one in this session we have to discuss the last one concept. Now let us start our session. Okay. Explain about nested decision structures. Nested decision structure means one decision structure inside one more decision structure. One decision structure inside one more decision structure. That type of declaration is called nested decision structure. Nested decision structure. Now I am drawing a paint. Now I am opening paint window. For your understanding purpose, I want to draw one diagram also here. Actually, this is one if condition. This is one if condition. Here one colon symbol is also must and shouldly required. So this is one if condition. Inside one more if condition we have to write, that is nested. If you want to declare one if condition inside one more if condition, then that type of declaration is called nested decision structure. Nested decision structure. I hope you understand about all those things. Hope you understand about this concept. This means if this condition is true, if this condition is true, if this condition is true, then the control will enter into the inside if condition. Again, here it will validate. Here it will check the inside if condition. So, when the inside if condition will execute, compulsory outside if condition should be true. Then only the control will enter into the if block, and inside if block contain one more if condition. If it has, then it will validate again. So first, inside if condition if you want to execute, then compulsory outside if condition should be true. So otherwise, if it is false, the control will not enter into the inside. The control will not enter into the inside if condition, and it is not validated by the controller. So that's why compulsory it should be true. So for your understanding purpose, here I draw one diagram. So now practically I have to show right now. So what is the meaning of actually nested decision structure? It means one decision structure inside one more decision structure declaration is called nested decision structure. Nested decision structure. One decision structure inside one more decision structure. If you have to declare, then those type of process is called nested decision structures. So we can use any combination of if else and elif. Actually, the combination means in C language, how to write the if condition like this. If condition opening bracket closing bracket. So inside one more if condition. So this type of conditions are called nested decision structures. Nested decision structures. Now understand now? Here statements we have to write. Whatever the statements we need for our as per our requirement, that statement we have to write inside if condition. And here also align with this if condition, other statements also, if we have, then we have to write, no problem. and after if condition or before if condition, as you wish, as per your requirement. So compulsory, if you want to execute inside if condition or inside statements, compulsory this condition should be true, otherwise the control will not enter into that block and not enter into that block, and the control will transfer to the next level of statements. Next level of statement it will execute. So if it is true, then inside control will transfer to the inside of block, and inside whatever the statements you have, that statement will execute. After that, inside nested if condition is there now. Here also it will check the condition. If this condition is true, then this condition is true, then the control will again enter into the inside block also. And here also, if you want to execute more number of statements, then there you have to write the statement will execute based on that given condition only. So inside if condition, if you want to execute, then compulsory outside if condition should be true. If it is false, then inside if condition is also, it will not validate by the controller. So that is the meaning of nested if statement. I mean nested decision structure. Here we can use any number of combinations. Actually, how many combinations we have? If condition, if else condition, if this is completely related to C language, but coming to Python programming language, In Python language, here also if statement combination is there, if else combination is also there, but in C language here if else if, but in Python programming language if elif else, this is the structure. So if condition means if you want to write one decision structure inside one more decision structure by using these three combination, if you want to write, then you have to write, no problem. But according to our project requirement, then we have to use these many combinations, nothing but one if condition inside one more if condition. This is related to statement. This is related to C language. So this combination is here. First, I have taken first if condition. So based on this if condition, here I have to write like this. Here I have written like this. One if condition inside one more if condition. If I want to write this entire block into else block also, then we can use, no problem. Then I have to use that combination also for your understanding purpose. So second one, this is first one, first combination. This is second combination. If condition opening bracket closing bracket statements, now else I am writing now else block, opening bracket closing bracket, in between, and nested decision structure, if we want to use in else block also, then that combination also useful, happily you can use, no problem. Opening bracket closing bracket statements, for your understanding purpose. Carefully observe. The second condition, if else condition, nested if structure, where I have to use it? Where I have used it? In else block na. So that combination you can use, no problem. If you want to use one if condition inside one more if condition, so that is also called nested decision structure. If you want to use inside else block also, then you can happily use. There is no problem for that. It can also accept. And like that, if else if condition also, if you want to use, then use. Happily you can use. So that is the combination of, we can use any combination. If you want to develop a nested structures, then in according to as per your requirement, if you want to use any combination, then you can happily use. There is no problem for that. Compiler it can accept, but the syntax should be compulsory in correct way. We can use in correct way. Otherwise it will show the error. So now I have shown the example for the C language. For the C language. So now I am removing this part. So this is Python syntaxes. If you want to use Python nested decision structure, for that the first combination is like this. If condition, for the condition purpose, if you want to use the brackets, then you can use happily. But here I haven't used it right now. Here, if I want to declare any block for the if condition, compulsory one indentation space must and should be required. That's why I'm giving one space. This space can identify this complete line is belongs to that related if condition. Now understand? So statement space is also must and should be required. If you want to declare any block, semicolon not required. Statement one. So again, one more space I am giving. Nested structure, nested decision structure. One more if condition I am writing. So that's why I given one space here. Here also I am writing one condition for that. And semicolon, colon symbol must and should be required. Here one space for outside if condition and one more space for inside if condition. Two spaces I am giving here. That space is giving for identification purpose. It is also related to inside if condition block. Here statement one. Next one more two spaces I mean for the inside if condition purpose. One more two spaces I given here. Statement two. Now understand na? So these two statement related to if condition. These complete statements, I mean these complete four lines are treated as a four statements for this out if condition, outside if condition. So if this condition is true, then the control will comes enter into the inside block. So statement one will execute after that, as well as if condition it is also, it will validate by the interpreter. After that, inside if condition, it is, if it is true, then these two statements will execute. Otherwise, if this condition is false, these two statements are also will skip by the interpreter, and the control will comes out to the outside if condition. Now understand na? So one if condition inside one more if condition, this type of declaration is called nested decision structure. So for that outside if condition purpose, I given one space here. For the inside if condition purpose, I given two spaces here. This type of space is called indentation space. So if you want to declare any inside decision structure, I mean nested decision structure, so compulsory these syntaxes should need to follow by the programmer while developing time. Otherwise it will show the errors. And this is if related combination. This is if related combination. And next, second combination I am developing for your understanding purpose. If condition colon, same one space is required to declare a block. Here I am writing statement one, and after that else. Here also one colon must and should be required, because of here I want to declare one if condition in the else block. So that's why I giving one space for to declare indentation block. So that indentation block contain is what? Again if condition. Again, one more if condition. Here one colon symbol must and should be required. And after that, for the else related purpose, I given one space. For inside nested block purpose, one more space I given. So this block is completely related to inside if block. Now I am giving the intimation to the compiler. Intimation to the interpreter. Sorry, interpreter, not a compiler. Compiler only using for compilation purpose. That is internal process. But interpreter need to understand about all those things. And here I am writing the statement for nested statements, nested condition structure. Statement 2. So now after that, these two statements are related to inside if condition. Now I am closing the else block. So how can I close this one? By removing space before the statement, that block will close automatically. So statement 1 I am writing, I mean next level of statement, this one. So if I remove this space here, that if block is that else block is also closed, that if block is also closed. Now understand, now this space is given to opening purpose. So next last space is given to closing purpose. So if you haven't given any space before the statement, then that block will close by the interpreter automatically. Nothing but a bracket. Don't think in other way. Actually, if you give the space, opening block is opened by the interpreter. If the remove the space, that before line statement, that last statement will closer by the interpreter automatically. That block is also closer by the interpreter automatically. You no need to close that one. Just remove that space is also. So this is called if else combination. Like that, if you want to use any combination by using these three combination, if else, if you want to use any combination, then you can use one condition, one decision structure inside, one more decision structure. If you want to use according to as per your requirement, then you can use. Like that, you can use number of combinations, number of steps also. Okay, na? As per your requirement. The Python software, it can automatically support. But syntax rules should need to follow by the programmer while developing time. And here I given the example syntax. If the condition executes when condition 1 is true. And inside block. If this condition is true, then the control will enter into the inside if block. And inside if block, it will execute. If this condition is false, this entire block will not executed by the interpreter. Automatically, the control will comes out to the if condition and it will execute the next level of statements. In the above syntax, if the condition 1 is true, then inside. So all those points here are given for your understanding purpose. Just read that three lines. Here I given the flowchart. Text expression means our required condition. Here we have to write. This is flowchart for your understanding purpose. Here I given flowchart is also in the text expression place. Here we should give the conditions. If this condition is true, then inside if block will execute. If inside if block will check again, the body of inside body of the statements will execute. If it is false, it will not execute by the interpreter. Okay, na? So this is true condition. So that's why the control will pass into the inside block. If the false condition will execute, that text expression will be false, then the body of else it will execute. Statement just below of it. Now understand? Next. Practically, I'm showing right now. For that, I'm opening the Python interpreter software. Ideally shell window. Sorry, notepad I am open because of at runtime it will execute clearly. Same program I am typing, all of you carefully observe. First, I need to take the input. After that, after taking that input, I need to store in one variable also. Input are you student or staff. Here one question I am asking. So by reading this line in the screen, the user need to enter one value. So that value I need to validate here. So for that, actually decision structures, what purpose we are using? To validate based on our session, I mean based on our given condition. If that value is true, then immediately that block will execute. So conditions here, our decisions will validate by the interpreter. So the decision is requirement by the, we need to collect the decision from the user first of all. After that, the based on given input, it will check the, I mean it will validate by the interpreter by using decision structures. So here I am validating. For that one if block I am writing, if person equal to student, then student related block it will execute. For that I am writing one if block. So here I am writing one statement, now print statement related if condition, compulsory one indentation space must and should be required here. So that's why I am giving one indentation space here. Print welcome message I am printing here, welcome to my dear student. So if the user may give student or staff, so user may student or staff, anyone it is possible. So if it is a student, then here the control will validate here. If it is a student, the given input is student, then this block will execute because of it is executing by the depends on our condition. So whatever the condition which is, I mean here I configured person equal to student. By reading that line, if the user enters student the value, student as a value, then internally it will check person equal to student. Then that those two values will compare here by using this assignment operator. Immediately this block will execute because of the input is student. While executing time, you can understand about all those things. So after that, one extra line I am printing. For that, without argument, I am typing here print function. After that, course. Sorry, after that, else statement I am using. Print. Here also an indentation space must and should be required to declare a block. Here I am opening one bracket. Again, if the person may be a staff, if the person might be a student or a staff, so based on that given input the blocks will execute. If it is equal to, if the given input equal to is equal to student, then student block will execute. Here student block is nothing but this block. Here I am selecting, all of you carefully observe, this is completely related to student block. If the user may enter a staff as a value, then else block will execute. Then else block will execute. Welcome to our respected staff. Respected staff. So these two blocks it will execute. So finally, for the student purpose also and for the staff purpose also, one message need to print. That is thank you message. Thank you message need to print for that. This line is for all users purpose. So here I removed space na. If the condition is true, if the given condition is true, then these two lines will execute. If the given condition is false, control will comes to the else block, these two lines will execute. After that the control will comes into the last line. This line always executed. All of you carefully observe. Now I am saving nested if.py. Save as type is all files. Now I am saving on desktop this file. Now I am opening command prompt for executing purpose. Here I just used if else condition. I haven't used nested decision structures. Now understand? Only if else condition I am using here. Cd desktop. And next one, on the desktop, the file name is nested if. So now I am pressing enter. It is asking, are you student or staff? So all of you carefully observe. Here I am entering student. then student block will execute. Welcome to my dear student. And remaining part will not execute na. All of you carefully observe. If this is equal to student, if the given input is equal to student, here it will validate. The if decision structure is validated by the given input. So this input and this configured name and the entered name both are same, then it will execute these two lines. If this line is not matched by given input, then else block will execute. So all of you carefully observe. One more time I am executing. So instead of student, I am using staff as an input. I giving staff as an input. So welcome to our respected staff. Thank you. So the next block will execute and else block will execute and here else block has executed right now. So thank you message always executing. All of you carefully observe. So here the concept is nested decision structure. So nested means one if condition, one decision structure inside one more decision structure declaration process is called nested decision structure. So after, if you enter as an input, if you enter input like a student, then again you need to check now, are you become student or BSc students. So that's why I'm writing one more statement. Print, are you become or BSc student? Now I am asking one question. For that this line, actually if you enter student as an input, then only the control will enter into this block. Otherwise the control will not enter into the this block and this line will not executed. So here I am checking, here I am writing one more if condition. What is that? Course is also must and shouldly required. This line I am writing course equal to input of this one I am asked. If course equal to BCom, then two indentation spaces I given here because of inside if structure na. So that's why two spaces I given. Print, welcome to Commerce Department. Otherwise, one space must and should be required because of this entire block related to if condition, outside if condition. So that's why I'm giving one space. So inside if condition, nested if condition, inside if one more if condition is there na. If you want to declare a block for that inside if condition, two spaces must and should be required. That's why here I given two spaces here. Here I given two spaces. So after else, one colon symbol, again two spaces, print of. Meer the commerce department ka pothe inkokati em undi ikkada BSc science department na. Welcome to science department. That line here I am writing here. Now I am saving same file I am executing. All of you carefully observe. Are you student or staff? Now I am entering student as a input. So it is asking, welcome to my dear student, are you BCom or BSc student? So now I am entering BCom as a input. So what it is showing? Welcome to commerce department. Thank you. Thank you line is always printing. That line is printing always without interaction of if condition or an nested if condition, because of that line is not related to if condition. It is a normal statement. Now understand na? So here all of you carefully observe. Nested decision structure means one structure, already one decision structure we have, normal decision structure, and that decision structure is also we have declared one more decision structure. So ante manam ok sari validate chese tappudu outside de edaithe undo dani base cheskoni inside lo kuda manam ok validation undi check cheskovali. ఇప్పుడు మీరు అర్థమవుతుంది ఏటీఎంకి వెళ్తారు ఇఫ్ యూ గో టు ద ఏటీఎం ఇట్ విల్ ఆస్క్ వన్ క్వశ్చన్ ప్లీజ్ ఇన్సర్ట్ ద కార్డ్ సో బై రీడింగ్ దట్ లైన్ ఇమీడియట్లీ యూ నీడ్ టు ఇన్సర్ట్ ద కార్డ్ ఐ మే కరెక్ట్ ఆర్ నాట్ సో ఆఫ్టర్ ఇన్సర్షన్ ఆఫ్ కార్డ్ అగైన్ ఇట్ విల్ ఆస్క్ ఎంటర్ యువర్ పిన్ సో బేస్డ్ ఆన్ దట్ ఫస్ట్ కండిషన్ అంటే నువ్వు కార్డ్ ఇన్సర్ట్ చేసినప్పుడు దట్ కండిషన్ ఇస్ షుడ్ బి ట్రూ సో ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ట్రూ ద ఇన్సైడ్ బ్లాక్ ఐ మీన్ అగైన్ వన్ మోర్ క్వశ్చన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆస్కింగ్ ప్లీజ్ ఎంటర్ యువర్ పాస్వర్డ్ అగైన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వన్ మోర్ టైమ్ వ్యాలిడేటింగ్ ఫర్ యువర్ పిన్ వ్యాలిడేషన్ పర్పస్ ఇఫ్ యూ ఎంటర్ రైట్ పిన్ దెన్ దట్ రైట్ దట్ రిలేటెడ్ పేజ్ ఇట్ విల్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ ఇఫ్ యూ ఎంటర్ రాంగ్ పిన్ దట్ ఎర్రర్ మెసేజ్ ఇట్ విల్ ప్రింట్ సో లైక్ దట్ ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ టు వ్యాలిడేట్ ఏ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ వ్యాలిడేషన్స్ ఫర్ దట్ డెసిషన్ స్ట్రక్చర్స్ ఆర్ వెరీ యూజ్ఫుల్ సో హియర్ ఐ గివెన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ కేర్ఫుల్లీ అబ్జర్వ్ నౌ నెస్టెడ్ డెసిషన్ స్ట్రక్చర్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో ఓవర్ ఐ హోప్ యూ అండర్స్టాండ్ అబౌట్ దిస్ సెషన్ అండ్ ఇన్ ద నెక్స్ట్ సెషన్ వీ విల్ డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ ద స్ట్రింగ్స్ పార్ట్ హౌ టు కంపేర్ టూ స్ట్రింగ్స్ హౌ టు కంపేర్ టూ స్ట్రింగ్స్ ఐ మీన్ ఒక రెండు స్ట్రింగ్స్ లేదా టూ నేమ్స్ని అలాంటి వాటిని కంపేర్ చేసే కాన్సెప్ట్ గురించి ఇన్ ద నెక్స్ట్ సెషన్ వీ విల్ డిస్కస్ ఓకే టుడే సెషన్ ఐఎమ్ ఎండింగ్ రైట్ నౌ ఐ హోప్ యూ ఎంజాయ్డ్ దిస్ సెషన్ సో ప్లీజ్ ట్రై టు అండర్స్టాండ్ అండ్ లిసన్ ద క్లాసెస్ కేర్ఫుల్లీ దెన్ ఓన్లీ ద నెక్స్ట్ పార్ట్ విల్ అండర్స్టాండ్ అదర్వైజ్ యూ కెనాట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ద నెక్స్ట్ పార్ట్ సో పైథాన్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ ఈస్ నౌ ప్లేయింగ్ అన్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ రోల్ ఇన్ ద మార్కెట్ సో ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ టు గెట్ ఎనీ జాబ్ ఆన్ ద పైథాన్ సో కేర్ఫుల్లీ లెర్న్ ద ఫండమెంటల్ కాన్సెప్ట్స్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ సెషన్స్ సో దెన్ ఓన్లీ యూ హ్యావ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ఓకేనా థ్యాంక్ యూ అమ్మా